playing for Navy personnel, mostly. As many as 30, 40,000 men. And we were sitting on an improvised bandstand made up of beer kegs. And we played concerts for them. Paratroopers, Marines, Navy, Army, it was all one service out there. Then, one of the most amazing engagements we played on that whole tour, we played the USS Saratoga, which was, I think at that time, the largest aircraft carrier in the U.S. fleet. And that was a marvelous thing because they put us on the flight deck, on the top deck of the ship, and the men were assembled down below in the aircraft deck. And the flight deck went down slowly, like the Paramount Theater or Strand Theater in reverse. The flight deck went slowly down as we hit our theme song, and suddenly we saw 3,000 men sitting there in dress whites. And as we came down into that cavernous thing where all the planes were kept, a roar went up such as you've never heard in your life. It was really one of the most incredible experiences I've ever had. I thought I was pretty inured to applause and all that sort of thing, but this was really gutting. And as the old saying, brought a lump to your throat, it sounds silly, but it really did. I mean, it was difficult to play for. We finished the show that night and ended with a Star Spangled Banner. It's a pretty corny song, you know. But at that moment, it took on some real meaning. For the first time, it dawned on me that what we were doing musically at that point had an enormous significance for the men who were out there. At one point, I simply couldn't handle it anymore. I took a long walk, and suddenly I found myself almost blacked out. And I found myself talking to a couple of Navy corpsmen, and they said, "What's the matter, sailor?" And I said, I don't know what's going on. I need some rest. I gotta get away from all this." They called a doctor. The doctor, as it turned out, was a psychiatrist. He looked at me and found out who I was, and he said, "What are you doing?" I said, "Well, I don't know what I'm doing. I really don't know anymore. One place I go, they say, 'Oh, Artie Shaw, what do you want?' Another place, 'Who do you think you are? Where do you think you are? You think you're in Hollywood?' And, I mean, all I wanted to do was be left alone to do what I came there to do. And it was impossible. Anyway, this psychiatrist sequestered me in a Quonset hut all by myself. See, Guadalcanal was our forward air base. And the further up toward the Japanese you got, the more danger was that a plane would come over. They were bombing us almost every night in Guadalcanal. And at that point, we saw dogfights in the sky at night. It was amazing to see yourself standing on a beach and yelling, "Get the dirty so-and-so," and watching a Japanese plane being shot at and burning. And you know that in there is a human being burnt to death. And you're standing like a savage because they've been bombing you day after day after day. War does very weird things to people.